what's different about directing like an Audible production like this than directing anything else?
Well, it's, you know, it's funny, the whole thing of like, you know, when you're directing like, you know, video stuff or like TV or sketch or anything like that, it's like there's a lot of different things that like you have to keep track of, like the blocking, where they stand, where like they're at, like where the, you know, the look, the lighting, sound, but like the performance kind of gets lost. It, like it kind of like shuffles down, and like the, you're looking for the least amount of stuff to go wrong in every aspect. Where with like the audio thing, it really kind of showed me, it kind of was like taught me like that I could like really zero in on just the performance, and then because you're starting to kind of like listen to the stuff, and you're like, it's like, oh, if you just read it, yeah, that's like, it gets the point across because you're taking in the information. But what if it makes it so like it feels like this is happening in the space? So it's like doing the stuff kind of going like, it's like, oh, it's up to like, it's up to us, like in the sound design, to decide. And even sometimes in the performance, it's like, remember, you start at the door, but then you walk up to them. So like, have that energy kind of coming in. And because it's like, if you were just to read the lines as if we were just here staying static, but like, it's like, you know, like we would speak at the same volume. But if I started to come up closer to you, I would get a little more quiet and intimate. So like, you have to kind of remember that stuff within a scene. And that's the stuff that was like super fun to nerd out about. It's like, because I was never a theater guy. Like, you know, I did like live sketch and stand up, and then went straight into like doing video sketches and TV stuff. And so to kind of like, you know, feel like, you know, it's like, you know, like reading an Uta Hagen book and just being like, it's like, I know about acting, you know. But it was really just like, like very fortunate. And everyone was so good. Like, everyone was just such a, like, they're all, these were all actors that were doing this stuff, you know. It's like, you know, when you're directing like a comedian person, it's like, they're just like, you're like, well, it'll be funny and I'll have to work on it a bit. But like, being so quickly able to, except, you know, Lily Petrie, who's like very new to this stuff, like she was so good at kind of like, I'd be like, it's like, oh, remember, Lily, it's like, kind of like, if you're getting overwhelmed, you don't know how to process these feelings, so you're going to start like crying, but you're angry that you're crying because you're kind of a teen kid that doesn't like you when they're trying to act tough. And then she's like, oh, okay, and then like does the like the scene, and I'm just like, oh yeah, that's good. Yeah, you know, like, it's like just completely was able to lock in. And you know, like even with like London, like, you know, she's just like just destroying, like that character's so funny. It's like it's just a joke machine, you know. But then like to like, it's like she, I would have to remind her, I was like, oh no, London, so this scene, it's like it's actually kind of sad. And like, and her reaction, she's like, I don't want to be sad. I was like, use that. Yeah, like it was always so easy with London to kind of go like, it's like, just do you.
When it comes to something like this, because like, did you have to storyboard it out? Did you already have sound design kind of ideas going in? Like, it just, when listening to it, there's so much happening, wouldn't even know where to start.
Yeah, you know, like that's the thing that was kind of overwhelming to me at first, was just like, and I made a bunch of notes in the script of like, you know, like, this is what I think should sound like. This is like different, like, we should put a cue in here, we should have them separate and make this person pacing around, stuff like that. And like, I'd never done anything like this, so it's like, I was like, hey, see if you can do it. I don't know, like, you know, it's just like, and I thought it was gonna be like library sounds or whatever, you know. And like, then when we got our first pass back from Mumble, I was just like, I was like, what? This is impossible? Like, and then like, you know, then your brain starts thinking, I was like, could you also make it sound like, you know, you start to really like kind of like dive in. They were such good collaborators in that way, where they kind of like showed us what was possible. And then like, when you don't have the, you know, the vocabulary for like, you know, that world, because it's like, can the portal sound bigger? You know, it's like, what does that even mean? Like, you know, like, it's like, I need it to be like 10 feet bigger, and you're like, but that's spatial stuff. And like, and so I try to start going like, you know, maybe like bring in like the low end, like bass it up, and maybe that if there's a rumble, and they're like, we got you. And like, they were very, it was like, yeah. And at times that's like, I was starting to go like, I think I might be adding too much, and then like we scaled back some of the sounds and stuff like that. But it was exciting, because it just like, the idea of just like, you know, being able to close your eyes and still take in such a visual story was very, very important to me.
Are you a fantasy geek guy? Do you like fantasy? Are you into the genre?
Yeah, I mean, like, it's like, I'm not, like, it's, I was a horror kid growing up. Like, it's like in, like, when horror and fantasy would combine. Like, yeah, I think Legend is, like, I consider that a horror movie, you know, as a horror fantasy. But it's like, I always enjoyed it, and I always liked that genre, because I grew up like in the 80s, where there was like just a ton of fantasy being made. And so like, it's like, I like it, but it's, you know, that feeling where you get into like maybe a community or a group of friends, someone that know more about it than you, and so you kind of retreat because it's like you're like, well, I don't like it as much as them, so I guess I don't like it. Which is like, you know, like I'm not saying that that's like nerd culture, gatekeeping stuff in general, but that was just like a personal like, you know, thing that happened to me where I was like, you start to go, well, I don't really know much about it. Like, it's like, do you like fantasy? It's like, yes, I do. And then like, you will like, do you like this one? You're like, I don't know. And they're like, oh, you poser, you know. Because I grew up like a punk rock kid where it's like, you just like the fear of being called a poser was just like, you know, life or death. And so like, I do like it so much. And I did watch a lot of kind of like the older stuff from my youth, like revisited, you know, Neverending Story and Labyrinth. I mean, like I'm a huge Labyrinth kid, but also I was way into David Bowie. So it's like, you know, I was just like, you can combine all my favorite things.
Any particular directors inspired you?
Yeah, like for this one, I thought a lot about Taika Waititi stuff. Taika with, you know, Hunt for the Wilder People, and of course, like what we do in Shadows, and like Richard Wilder's Joker, but Jojo Rabbit, which I think is. It's like, it's funny and it's light and it's stylish, but then there's these like gut punch, you know, like moments, and that's like the thing that I thought, and like, you know, I grew up being obsessed with Mel Brooks, and so like his stuff is always so good because it's like, I mean, like the earlier stuff where it's like he wasn't doing straight up parodies, it was just like a funny version of that. Like also, you know, Edgar Wright's Simon Pegg movies. It's like, I thought a lot about Shaun the Dead, which is not like a parody of zombie movies, it's a funny zombie movie.
Yeah.
And so with this show, it's like, this is an, and it was like an early kind of version of like, where this was kind of like, had a lot more references to like, you know, like auto and stuff like that, but like we stripped them all out. And like it made it better because now it's not just, it's, it can exist on its own. It could just be a fantasy thing that is really funny and, you know, and yeah, so yeah. I can keep going. But yeah, that's kind of like, it's like, those are the kind of directors that I like, I'm obsessed with and, you know, like, yeah.
How did you end up involved in the project?
So Felicia and I had known each other for years, we're buds, and we worked on a show for a few seasons, and on the last season we I directed her, and then there was like, that was the first time we had that dynamic. We had like performed together and we were buds, we did cons and movies, we were friends. But like that was like the first time like where it's like we really found like, it's like, oh wow, that's like, there's a nice little back and forth here. Like, it's like we both kind of like, we like the things in each other that like work well for us, you know, and like she'll give me like a note on something and I'll be like, oh yeah, that's great, like, and then like, and vice versa. And so she was kind of gearing up to do this thing, and she was like, after, you know, I was directing those, that stuff, she was like, would you want to like maybe meet about directing on this thing? And I was like, yeah, sure. I mean, I don't know anything about that world. Like, and I've never even like directed like a cartoon, you know, and like, and she's like, yeah, but like, you have my head. I mean, like, I'm going to be like inundated with like being the star, where it's like where it's like, you know, and I've been in that same position before where it's like, it's my show, it's my thing, like that's like, and then you start to feel that your performance is less than because like you're involved in so many aspects of it. So she knew that I would help her stay as narcissistic as possible to be able to really do a good performance. And so yeah, that's kind of how like it worked out, and I couldn't be like more stoked. I just like, it's her thing, and I just like, it's weird to even talk about, like it was like I directed it, it was like I just like helped her facilitate this amazing idea, and that's like the thing I'm really excited about.
Cool.
Yeah.
Is there a behind-the-scenes video of this? Because everybody is describing how they were working in the booth, and it sounds crazy. Is there a video anywhere?
Primarily London.
We must. But it was weird the way it was set up. Like even like it's like it was because like, they have little sound stuff around them, and like we didn't want to move too much during the thing. But I know we did, and I think we talked about it a bunch. And just setting up. You know what? I think we had like Zoom camera set up for like Audible to like tune in. And I bet those were recorded.
Oh. Yeah.
Yeah. But like, it's funny because like I remember like just let it go, like ooh, like just standing hands down. And I was like, run and move. And I'm like, she's like, why? And I was like, because it doesn't sound right. And then like she did it, like she's like, and then she's like, oh.